Bobby! No, 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 no! Oh my gosh, she's about to leave the bunker! No! Did I forget to lock a door or something? Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh! Don't you dare! No, no, no! Close it quick! Oh my god!
G'day Bambies, Kaleido here, and welcome to a brand new series here on my channel called the Barbie Bunker Challenge in The Sims 4. Oh my god, I've just been so excited to finally start this series. I just uploaded the creator sim of our lovely Barbie Roberts right here that you guys can see, and I'm just so pumped to finally play her because she is just so adorable. If you guys haven't watched that video already, I'll leave a card for you guys to go and check it out for yourselves. I talk a lot about the series over there. But today I have even more information about the series because of course this is part one. Yay, I'm so keen. So what is the Barbie Bunker Challenge, you may ask? Well, this is a random challenge that my boyfriend and I kind of created together. Well, actually my boyfriend thought of the idea and I've just put my knowledge about The Sims 4 into it with my own storytelling ways because I love telling stories and I thought this would be a fun way to explore some of the aspects of the Strangerville game pack, which I haven't actually played a lot. Speaking of which, I never got around to playing this game pack back when I first got it, and EA actually gave me this copy of Strangerville, so even though this is a very late video, I just want to say this challenge is brought to you by EA Game Changers. Thank you so much, EA, for giving me this copy. I really appreciate it. But yeah, I just wanted to make sure I said that because it's very important. Let's just get into the challenge story and rules already. You guys are probably like, oh my god, we want to know more. Here we go. It's the end of the sim world as we know it. The mysterious disease in Strangerville was neglected by a certain rainbow simmer and spread around the globe. I think that's me, guys. I think that's me. Good news, aliens are here to help, but bad news, aliens are purging all existence to exterminate the pest that spreads the disease. Luckily, Barbie's late grandfather built a bunker under her family home and escapes into the tunnels just in time. Sadly, her grandfather didn't pass on much information about the bunker in his journals besides the entrance door keys. Barbie has to find a way to survive and unlock the bunker's secrets on her own. Pedicures and hair straighteners aside, it's time for Barbie to bolster up some courage and skill to survive. What hidden rooms will Barbie discover? Will she be able to retain her sanity in this lonely hole in the ground? It's up to you now. And that is up to us, guys. We are going to be doing this together. I actually wrote up these rules and what you need to join me in this series. So if you would like to play along with me, like in your own game, make sure you go and check out the rules. I'll have them down below in the description bar. But yeah, I put some time into that. It's going to be updated, probably episodically. It's not your traditional challenge rules because I'm going to be growing the rules and the lists of it as we progress throughout the series. So I'm sorry if we only have like one step on there right now, but I am going to be growing it as we play the series. Anyways, I hope that all makes sense to you guys. I'm not going to continue reading it because I know that'll bore you guys, but basically you have to have the paranoid and cheerful traits, but I also have the handy trait, which is a custom content trait by Kawaii Stacy. So that's going to be very helpful. We also have the archaeology scholar aspiration. So it's going to be very helpful, especially when it comes to digging around in the bunker, trying to figure out how to continue living, because you guys are going to see the issue at hand very soon. But before we do that, let's go and have a quick look at Barbie's outfits, which of course, Barbie has to be doing survival mode in style. Her clothing has to be on point during this whole endeavor. So we have the first one, which is very survival-esque. I like the UGG boots, you know, comfortable and functional somewhat. The next one, we have these
overalls, which I thought were just so adorable. I found them online and I just thought they were so cute. Here we have a more Indiana Jones look. This is so like archaeologist. I don't know why I added this one, but okay. All right. And then we have Smarty Pants Barbie. So she is a scientist. Oh yeah. I guess she may have found some of the lab coats that were down in the bunker and she thought it was pretty cute. I'm sure anything would look cute on this sim. She is absolutely adorable. I'm so happy with how she turned out. Next up, we have her formal wear, which is so dainty and cute. Her athletic wear is also adorable. Very rainbow for Pride Month. Even though it's the end of the world, Barbie still wants to show her support for Pride Month. Next up, we have her sleepwear, which is very simple and kawaii. I love the slippers. Her party wear is very sheer, very like Clueless vibes. I was getting a lot of comments saying that she does kind of remind people of Cher from Clueless, and I love that. I love Clueless. Such a good movie. I need to watch that again. Here is her swimwear. I'm not sure if we're even going to be able to like go to a party or if we're going to be able to go swimming, but you never know what we could run into in this challenge. And then we have her summer wear. Again, though, it's the end of the world, but Barbie is just ready for any kind of weather here. She also has a winter look, which, oh my god, this is so cute. This is my favorite outfit ever. We got the snowman little earrings, the different layers that she's wearing, the skivvy underneath, and the hat and the pants. Oh my gosh, it just looks perfect. I love this look. I wish I had this look in real life. Alrighty, well, that is Barbie. We should just go ahead and pop in game already. This first episode is going to be a little bit more like setting the foundry so then you guys kind of understand things. I am going to be pumping out these episodes a lot faster than I usually do my series because I'm just feeling really invigorated lately. So yay, I'm keen for this new series. Let me know your excitement down below in the comment section. So here we are in the bunker. I don't want to go too far above the ground because, you know, it's very toxic up there. Aliens have been dropping loads of bombs and it's been bad news bears. But anyways, here is the entrance of the bunker. So like the story said, Barbie found her grandfather's journal. And in that journal, she found the key to go through these first two doors. She didn't even know this was here. She would just go down here to grab whatever, like pickles or whatever that were down here, and she didn't even notice that there were these giant doors at the back here. Anyways, I might as well do a little bit of a tour for you guys so you kind of understand, but we do have a shower, but it is actually a decontamination one, and Barbie isn't really all about that. She doesn't really like the shower. And we have two locked rooms up here. Now, one of them is so tempting. We have a fully stocked kitchen, which is locked. It has a pantry. And Barbie is getting hungry. All she has is a cooler, which is down there. She has a cooler and she also brought down her popcorn machine. She just really wanted that popcorn machine, you know? It's all she can muster to bring down with her. But she also brought her yoga mat, which is interesting. I don't know why she would think that's helpful for the end of the world, but she did. She's got to keep her zen, you know? And then we also have another locked room here, which is the bathroom. There's an actual shower, a toilet, and we have lots of dryers and washing machines. She doesn't actually know what's in there at all, but she wants to unlock that as well. But we are going to aim to unlock both of these. These doors are pretty much identical. She's pretty sure that they use the same key. The key that she had found in her grandfather's journal doesn't open these doors. It doesn't open any of the other doors within the bunker. So that's really inconvenient. What Barbie has to do is figure out a way to get through these doors now. So that's going to take some skill. To unlock both of these rooms, Barbie is going to have to get to level 3 logic, level 3 handiness, and also level 2 mischief. So that is the only way that she's going to be able to unlock these two rooms. And then downstairs, we have this laboratory. And We're not sure how to get in. This door is very difficult compared to the other one. Totally different mechanisms. So she's going to have to learn a few other things. It's going to be much more difficult than the two upstairs. And that's going to take level 4 logic, level 4 handiness, and 3 body. She's going to have to put some strength into trying to break through this door. Now, poor Barbie is going to have to stay down here in the bunker. She's not allowed to leave the bunker because, you know, it's really scary outside. It's toxic, so she can't leave. And she also has to fix all of the items if they break. She's not allowed to replace them because, you know, we don't have stores and stuff at the end of the world, do we? And another rule that we have set for Barbie is that she has 0 skills. She has lived a life of convenience, just not really doing that much in the old world. We're gonna call it the old world because it's going to be totally different in like 50 years. Oh my god, Barbie is going to be alive in 50 years still. Oh, that makes me sad. But anyways, let's go ahead and cook some butter. Oh my gosh, I just realized that we started off with 23. What? I just made the biggest boo-boo. Okay, let's just real quick change that. We actually are starting with only 500 simoleons. My mistake, I forgot to change the money bag, but easy fix anyways. Yes, Barbie was only able to muster 500. It's weird, you buy food in The Sims 4, so there's no way for her to like have produce or anything, but we're hopefully in the future she'll be able to unlock some rooms, maybe something with a garden. That would be really cool. She also has some books and things here. Here is her grandfather's journal, so she can go ahead and view that. I don't think she's going to be able to find anything new in there though. Like, her grandfather was a little bit of a kook. No one believed him when he would talk about the end of the world, and she was so blown away to find that there was actually a giant bunker down here. Now, girl, your popcorn is all done, so go ahead and grab a serving. She has done so well to bring down as much stuff as she could down here anyways. So what we have is, of course, the popcorn machine. We also have a little bit of workout gear. We have a cooler with a little bit of provisions in it, so she'll be able to survive for a bit. We got some blankets, a little bit of a bed, and some other random technology that she doesn't know how to use at all. She has to get her skills up so then she can learn some more things. But if you guys are wondering where her grandfather is, he is actually passed away, but you never know, we might run into his ghost or something in the future. I feel like he could pop up at any time, to be honest. I hope she enjoys that popcorn because she's gonna have to survive off that popcorn for quite some time. All right, well, after you finish that, Barbie, I'm pretty sure we should get you started on your logic. Logic is the main one that we need to get her onto. I am going to allow us to buy books in this series, so we only have 500 to spend on food and also books and stuff. That's probably going to leave real quick, and we need to figure out a way to make money as well. We don't have an easel, so we can't make money that way. I think we might be able to sell sculptures though. We might be able to use the working bench. We'll try that. Barbie, no, oh my gosh, she's about to leave the bunker. No, did I forget to lock a door or something? Oh my gosh, don't you dare. No, close it quick. Oh my god. Okay, Barbie, we're going to have to have a shower in the decontamination thing after you just opened that door. Oh my god, are you crazy, girl? Do you want to die? Are you not taking this end of world stuff seriously? Oh my lordy lord, we're gonna have to lock this door. Save her from herself. We can't lock that door. I guess she has like the key memorized. So, oh my goodness gracious, Barbie. What are we gonna do with you? You're such a dips already. But we are gonna work on her. She's going to be a independent woman. She's going to be surviving all on her own down here. She can do it. I know she can. All right, let's go ahead and get her to get her logic up. Oh my goodness gracious. I cannot. Look how cheery she is. She was like walking around all happy. What? You nearly just died. You are so lucky that your grandfather installed a decontamination thing, because I think that you would be dead right now. Seriously. I feel like her grandfather is rolling around in his grave right now. Well, anyways, good news. We did get our first logic skill, our first skill. Oh my god. Hopefully she'll grow some brains. I feel so mean, but I just can't believe that she went upstairs. I know I forgot to lock that door. It's partially my fault. I need to grow some brains as well. Barbie and I have so much in common. I feel like I would probably forget that it's the end of the world too and just go upstairs. Alrighty, well, let's try to get her to level 2, but we can have a little bit of a sneak peek into the room next door. So we have this science lab. Ooh, it looks very cool. And if she gets her logic skill a little bit higher, I feel like there's a lot of things in there that she could probably use. I don't know. I just feel like it would be cool. And it also looks like there is a little bit of the plague here. I don't know why that is there. Maybe her grandfather had more to do with the disease than she thought. She thought that he was just some crazy guy. Maybe she should go over and read through that journal another time and see if she can find out some more secrets about him. But wow, she's feeling pretty chipper, isn't she? She seems really happy, even though she's all by her lonesome. Her mood is pretty good. Her social, oh no, I'm so scared to see her social go down. Like, what do we even do when her social goes down? I hope she doesn't like die of not being social. I feel like she's a little bit of social butterfly at heart, and she's already talking to herself. Oh dearie me. Is that good news? Bad news? No idea. Can we talk to other survivors through this portable laptop? Is that a thing that we can do? Like, she already is doing vlogging and stuff. I feel like she could possibly talk to other people online. That could be a great way to get her social up. But I don't know, is that cheating? Let me know down below in the comments, guys. I'm kind of writing these rules as I go. Okay, are we level 2 already? We're level 2! Yes! Okay, so we need to get our mischief up as well. We're nearly at level 3. What do we even have in here? Guess we'll have to open it up. Oh, we have nothing. We're gonna have to buy some books. I'm going to buy the mischief one because we really do need it. It costs 75. Oh my goodness. It's in there now. Perfect. It was just teleported. Amazon Prime just stepped up its game. It can now teleport random items into your inventory. How great is that? She's nearly a level 3. Oh my god. Okay, we need level 2 mischief. It's gonna be such a lonely life down here. So another thing about this series is that I will be getting you guys to help me choose rooms eventually. So maybe she'll create a key and it'll only be able to open one door, and then that key will break and it's like a unique one. She won't be able to make it ever again. Maybe after she unlocks the science room, both of these doors will be one key only and it's only one use. I'll be getting you guys help in choosing which room, and that's sort of like the thing that we're going to be doing in this series. That's why I didn't want to write all of the rules at once, because I feel like this series is going to be writing itself somewhat, and I think that'll be kind of cool. So I'll be having random stuff that will hopefully help her along her journey, and we'll be unlocking more and more different sections of the bunker as we go. Dude, I'm pretty sure we just hit level 3. Yes! Okay, it's time to get your mischief level up, girly. I don't know if we're going to be able to unlock the kitchen today, but I definitely feel like this is a great beginning to the challenge. She had a little bit of a hiccup. Barbie tried to escape the bunker already. She forgot that it was the end of the world, but that's all right. But yeah, guys, if you are interested to see the next episode where we'll probably unlock the kitchen and the bathroom, make sure you subscribe and click that bell for notifications so then you get notified when I upload the next episode, which I'm probably going to upload maybe not tomorrow, but the next day. I'm not sure how I'm going to go schedule-wise, but I'm just really excited. So these episodes are probably going to be coming out quite quickly. Again, you can find the Barbie Bunker Challenge rules and information link down below. It will be a Google Doc for you guys. Everything hopefully will be nice, neat, and tidy for you to read and follow along us on this journey. Let me know if you're going to be playing through this challenge with me. That would be fantastic. Alrighty, guys, well, I'll let you all go now. Thank you so, so much for watching. I love you all to bits, and I'll see you all next time. Thank you.